Ujjava model, two-sector model of economic growth. Introduction. The two-sector model of economic growth given by Ujjava is basically a neoclassical model. In Ujjava's model, there are two productive inputs, the labor and capital, which are substitutable to each other and freely transferable from one sector to the other sector. Thus, Ujjava introduced a two-sector and two-factor model in the neoclassical framework. Assumptions. There are two inputs, labor and capital. There is depreciation at a rate of mu. That means labor and capital both depreciate at a rate of mu. The labor and capital are substitutable for each other. Labor and machines are freely transferable from one sector to the other sector. The supply of labor is exogenously determined. Working of the model. Using notations K and L for capital and labor, K1 and L1 for capital and labor for investment or industrial sector, I sector, and K2 and L2 as capital and labor for consumption goods sector, C sector, it is said that each industry has an optimal capital labor ratio, that is K1 upon L1 for I sector and K2 upon L2 for consumption goods sector C. Since all the machines and the labor must find employment, then this can be written as K upon L, that is the total capital in the economy upon total labor, or ratio of total capital to the total labor in the economy, equal to K1 plus K2, that is the total capital in the first sector and second sector, upon L1 plus L2, that is the total labor in the first sector and second sector. Or the total capital is split into two sectors, K1 and K2, and total labor is split into two, L1 and L2. This can be written as K1 upon L1 plus L2 plus K2 upon L1 plus L2. Multiplying and dividing the first term by L1 and the second term by L2, we get K upon L is equal to K1 upon L1 plus L2 into L1 upon L1 plus K2 upon L1 plus L2 into L2 upon L2. This can be written as L1 upon L1 plus L2 into K1 L1, K1 upon L1 plus L2 upon L1 plus L2 into K2 upon L2. And this can be rewritten as K upon L is equal to L1 upon L1 plus L2 into K1 upon L1 plus this is written as L1 minus L1 upon L1 plus L2 into K2 upon L2. The above expression indicates that capital labor ratio K upon L has been split into the capital labor ratio for the capital goods sector and the consumption goods sector. The wage profit ratio W upon R determines the division of labor and machines between the two sectors. Both the capital goods and consumer goods sectors would make optimal adjustments, and these would yield unit cost. Perfect competition sets the price ratio P2 upon P1 for the two commodities equal to the ratio of unit cost. Thus, any W upon R determines, that is, wage profit ratio determines an equilibrium price ratio between P2 and P1. Conditions for stability. Ujjava assumes that wages are spent on consumer goods and profits are spent on machines. Given WR ratio, W upon R and K upon L, and the outputs Y1 and Y2, equilibrium in the commodity market requires that WL upon RK should be equal to P2 Y2 upon P1 Y1. The stability proposition states that capital labor ratio should remain constant, or it remains constant. This is possible only if the growth of capital is just equal to the growth of labor force, that is delta K upon K, which is the rate of growth of capital in the economy, minus delta L upon L, rate of growth of capital in the labor force, must be equal to zero. That means delta K upon K should be equal to delta L upon L. Another condition for stability proposition is that consumer goods sector should be machine intensive or capital intensive than the investment sector. It can be written as K2 upon L2. K2 is a capital in the consumer goods sector. L2 is a labor in the consumer goods sector. So the ratio of K2 to L2 or K2 upon L2 must be greater than K1 upon L1. K1 upon L1 is a capital labor ratio in the investment sector. So capital labor ratio in the consumption goods sector must be greater than the capital labor ratio in the investment sector, where 2 represents the consumption goods sector and 1 represents the investment goods sector. It is a sufficient condition for stability, but it is not a necessary condition for stability. Criticisms. Many have criticized this model based on its weak assumptions. Frank Hain went further and called the assumptions regarding capital intensity and saving as terrible assumptions, which probably never or rarely hold true in the real world. It is thus reasonable to conclude from this exercise that, if anything, these models have taught us that the real world is a bit more complicated than the one sector models.